Hey, this is Jodey Hogeland, PowerStore Global Evangelist, and I'm joined here with my good friend Drew to talk about snapshot archiving. Drew?
Thanks, Jodey. Yeah, what I thought I'd start off with, Jodey, is let's describe a deployment or an architecture that I see often used in many of our customers today about how they're archiving their snapshots. So I'm in a production environment, so look, I've got a primary all flash array. I've got a secondary all flash array. And it's an important, enterprise application. So I'm taking lots of snapshots because I want to have the ability to recover in the event that something goes on. And so these snapshots are accumulating on both the primary and secondary storage array. Now, these are all flash arrays, enterprise grade storage. Snapshots take a lot of space.
Yeah.
And so,
so what you're saying is this can get expensive.
It can get very expensive. Exactly. But obviously snapshots are integral, and you never know how far and back in time you're going to have to go off and go. And so oftentimes what we see is, okay, we're going to bring yet another array into the equation here. Sometimes all flash, maybe it's hybrid to give yourself maybe a little bit more economic, dollar per gig kind of dynamic. But, we're only going to keep, a certain period of time of snapshots on this primary and secondary array. And, on this, we'll just call it an HFA for a second here, like I'll be dumping, more of those snapshots. And this is my repository in terms of my long-term history.
So that becomes your archive.
It becomes my archive, yeah. Exactly. But what's interesting is when we talk to customers about how they're deploying this, it's like, okay, well, this is still like an enterprise level array with a license associated with it. And in terms of like data efficiency, it's like, okay, maybe I can go get some cheaper media. But we're seeing like DRR rates here of like 2 to 1. And so for something that's an archive that's holding a lot of snapshots, this is a very expensive way to do it.
Correct.
There's got to be a better way.
Yeah, there is a better way, and I'm glad you asked, Drew.
Tell me more.
Yeah, I'll tell you more. So we have built in this technology that we call storage direct protection. Now, storage direct protection, or affectionately known as storage direct when it comes to PowerStore, gives us the ability to do what you were just talking about, Drew, by saying, hey, I've got my on-prem, I'm replicating to DR, maybe running workloads over there that I'm replicating back. So I'm leveraging these environments effectively, and I'm creating those snapshots just like you were giving in your example at site A and site B. But that long-term aspect of this is where things get to be a challenge. So that's the introduction of what we talk about with storage direct protection. And that is introducing direct integration with our PowerProtect. Now, PowerProtect gives us the ability to take these snapshots and archive them directly. And this is direct integration, right? So hence storage direct protection.
Yeah.
It is directly integrated into PowerStore and into PowerTech, the ability for these two infrastructures to communicate.
Yeah, I noticed you didn't draw a backup server in this diagram here at all.
Yeah, I didn't have to draw a backup server because it doesn't exist,
don't
right?
Need it. Yep.
So that's the beauty of being a portfolio company and being able to bring best of breed engineering into these architectures and saying, so now, we can take these, primary site A, site B, and we can start archiving those snapshots off to here. But instead of that 2-to-1 data reduction, we're talking about seeing upwards of 65-to-1 data reduction.
Wow. I mean, that's compelling. Like, I think about, 2-to-1 to 65-to-1. Like, the disks could almost be free over here, and I'm still paying more in terms of what I'm actually getting out of my archive here.
Yeah, so in this scenario, we're talking about pennies on the dollar.
Yep.
So getting that level of data reduction, but maintaining those customer environments that say, you know, hey, I need 7 years of retention.
Yep.
10 years, 30 years of retention.
Yep.
We can leverage the integration of PowerProtect and PowerStore via Storage Direct. And by the way, no additional licensing costs, right?
Right.
So if you own PowerStore and you own PowerProtect, this is directly integrated. So this is a key aspect of understanding, you know, what we're talking about by bringing all of this together.
Yeah. Well, in this scenario as well, though, Jodey, I'd like to touch on something like this archive array that we have set up here. It's likely in this one of the primary or secondary data centers as well. Like, where can I deploy this PowerProtect solution as we think about snapshot archiving?
Yeah, when we're deploying PowerProtect for customers, you know, you see it in the primary data center, so it could be an on-prem, or it could be in the cloud. And so customers get the option, as long as it's PowerProtect technology, you can deploy that on-prem, you can deploy that at the DR site, you can deploy that, you know, physical on-prem, physical DR, or virtual edition on-prem, virtual edition in public cloud. And by the way, already supported in every major hyperscaler is data domain virtual edition. So being able to take that PowerProtect technology, deploy it anywhere. And so whether I'm, you know, taking it and deploying it, you know, locally, you know, and creating, you know, physical copies, or maybe I'm shipping this off, you know, to, you know, PowerProtect inside of a public hyperscaler somewhere, I get the ability to recall those snapshots, crack open those snapshots, pull back just what I want to, and it's all directly integrated, no additional licensing, no additional software, and built right in, delivering massive amounts of savings to the customer.
So to answer my question, there is a better way.
There is a better way. Welcome to the world of PowerStore, PowerProtect, and Storage Direct Protection.
Great. Well, thanks, Jodey, for walking us through today. Hope you all found this topic of snapshot archiving useful and the power of Storage Direct. Thank you.